you bitches wanna look like me. Wanna be in demand, get booked like me. Wanna run up in a lab and cook like me, but ain't.
In real quick, but do not mind that hole right there. You guys see I'm pointing at it, but that's because I have young siblings, and when I be asleep they be barging into my room. Y'all see my door right there? They like make it a hole in the wall. So if y'all also do not mind the ugly ass braids that my mom put on this lace front, you see I got the thing over it to cover it, but life is life.
What's popping YouTube? Hold on, there's a corny. What's popping angels? It's your girl Shay. Back here again, another video, and guess what we're doing today? Today, we finna be like telling y'all about my experience with my belly piercing. Cause a lot of people, y'all been texting me on my social medias, my Gmail, asking me about it. So I'm finna tell y'all about it. So let's go. The first thing is, what I did was wrong was like I slept on my belly piercing. Like the first day that I got it, I slept on my stomach. Do not sleep on your stomach. Like, as soon as I got my belly pierced, I came home and I was asleep. And like, I woke up, I was on my stomach. Like, there it is, on my stomach. I never in my life slept on my stomach. But ever since I like got my belly pierced, I just got a habit of sleeping on my stomach. I don't know why, but do not do that, because they would like cause pain. It would just cause irritation. Don't do that. But it didn't cause irritation with me, but I heard that people said that they slept on their stomach and it caused irritation to them. So don't be like me and be stupid and do that. Like, no, don't do that. No, that's a big no. Get it professionally done. None of that. And also, when you're getting your belly button pierced, make sure they have a thing, the little brown thing, to like, so they won't poke themselves with it. I was interrupted, but as I was saying, like, make sure they have a little crock with it so they won't poke themselves. That's one thing that I did not like see that the lady did with me, but I trust her because she pierced my nose. She did all my piercings that I have now, except for these. I did this myself. My experience with my belly button pierce is it was not painful. As you guys can see, it was just a little pinch and it was over. But I have a high pain tolerance because I pierced my own ear. High pain tolerance, like I'm used to this shit. Like I'm used to pain, but it does not hurt. Just a little pinch. If you want to get it done, get it professionally done. Don't do it yourself unless you know what you're doing. And like, make sure they sanitize their stuff. Like, make sure they do it in front of you. They sanitize your stomach. They sanitize every tool that they use. Make sure, like, even before you're gonna go get your belly button pierced, make sure your belly button pierced. Cause like, say for instance, your belly button is pierced, your belly button, like, as they wipe it, they see dirt on it. You don't want nobody knowing that your belly button was dirty. And they're gonna be like, your shit is dirty, so I don't know if you're gonna take care of your belly piercing. You didn't take care of your belly button, so what makes you think you're gonna take care of your belly piercing? Also, everybody, belly button is not made for a belly piercing. Like, say for instance, you have an any outie, you cannot get a belly piercing. If you have an outie, you cannot get a belly piercing. You wanna know why? Because, like, this is your stomach, okay? And this is the belly piercing that you want. The belly piercing is gonna be sitting on your stomach like this. You cannot get that. Like, basically, it's gonna mess with the muscle of your outie, and you do not want that. That could cause, serious injuries into the muscles. Stuff like that. I repeat, everybody's stomach belly button is not meant for a belly piercing. I'm telling you this now. Like, if you go to somewhere and they be like, oh, you cannot get a belly piercing, that because they're telling you the truth. And if you end up getting a belly piercing, go somewhere else and they get you a belly piercing, that means they don't care for their stuff, and you don't want that. Just don't get it. Like, they will tell you what's right and wrong. Don't go to no ratchet ass motherfucker and they be like, oh, you wanna, okay, they do it just for the money. They serious about your health issues, everything. I got my belly button pierced when I was 15, and I got it pierced because, like, I had a legal adult with me. You go to a person that's legal, they know what they doing, they sanitize. Just don't go to no anybody, because that infection is serious. It's serious, very, very, very serious. 12. I got my belly button pierced January 12th, and today is March the 14th. So that means I have my belly button pierced for 3 months and 2 days. And yes, when you have your belly button piercing, you will like see white stuff coming out, and like, say for instance, you touch it, of course it's gonna sting. And make sure your belly button is not twisted, cause me, I always have my belly button twisted, and it's like, it's not straight. Like, it be twisted inside my, like, the hole that's inside my belly button. It's be twisted in it, and like, say if you try to move, of course it's gonna hurt. Also, just make sure you clean, sanitize, and do not take bath. I mean, you could take a bath if you bath with bleach, but just don't take no bath if you're not bathing with bleach, because you bathing your own filth and you don't want that bacteria to get inside your new piercing. And make sure the person who you go to, make sure they is serious about your health, serious about everything, not just for the money. Just make sure like you clean your belly button yourself, even if you see them clean it, and make sure they clean that shit in front of you. Just don't go to know anybody at all. And when you get your belly button pierced, it's gonna sting. Well, for me, it stings, but it did not hurt. As y'all can see, of course, I had a reaction because it's like, damn. I thought she only went through like the first hole, then she went through the second hole. You see what I'm saying? But no, she actually stuck it like in it. I was shocked because she did not let me, she did not count down. And I'm kind of glad that she didn't count down, because if she would have been start counting down, I would have been like, hold on, wait. And make sure when you get your belly button piercing that it's real gold, real silver. Because I had this piercing right here. I had both my nose pierced. And it got infected because this one was not real. And you see, this one is not infected because I went to the person who did my belly piercing. I had went to like a hair store because they were cheaper than when you get your nose professionally done. And I was trying to be cheap. And guess what? I ended up with an infected ass nose. I had a big ass bump. Green shit was coming out my nose. And how you know that your belly button piercing is like, is infected, is because like you would feel just so pain. And how you know that your belly button is disinfected, because green shit would start coming out of it. And like, also, like you would see, you can know, because you know when your stomach start messing up. I'm sorry, but I don't know what to say on the infecting part, because I don't know, because I never had an infected belly piercing. I had to fix the nose. And how I knew that my nose was getting infected, because you get a fat ass bump. And like, just don't change it. Wait until like a year or two, because that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna wait until a year or two to change my belly piercing, because I'm not trying to get infected and get it pierced over. And signs that it's healing is like when you get white pus in it, discoloration, and like you don't feel, like you feel pain, but you don't feel pain. You see where I'm coming from? Yeah. If you have low pain tolerance, just don't get it, because you're gonna embarrass yourself, love. Don't get it. That's the end of this video. And if you guys like videos like this, let me know down in the comments below if y'all want me to do a video on a nose piercing. Also, do not cut your skin, it's not paper. Get out of bed and make sure you eat something and drink and eat your fruits, because it's gonna be good for you. And get out of bed and get some fresh air. I know you started sitting in that bed, honey. Just go outside, look out the window, do something. Feel free to text me on my social medias or my Gmail, it's down in the description box below. Bye. Like, comment, subscribe. I promise you guys won't regret it. Wait. Bye,
Angel. But here it goes.